The coronavirus outbreak and fears of it spreading are also a concern right here at home. While there are no confirmed cases in Canada, some health officials say it's just a matter of time. Dr. Alon Weisman is an infectious disease specialist with the University Health Network, and he joins us now to talk about how hospitals are dealing with this situation and preparing for the possibility of an outbreak. Dr. Weisman, thank you for making time for us. I actually want to begin with the latest breaking news that we're hearing out of China, that now it's 41 confirmed deaths linked to the coronavirus. That is a jump of 15 individuals in a single day. And put in another way, it's a jump of 60% in a single day in terms of deaths. When you hear those numbers, what goes through your mind?
I think a lot of health agencies here in Canada, across the world, are looking at those numbers. On the one hand, it is quite shocking and quite a dramatic rise. On the other hand, I think a lot of agencies, including our hospitals here, are preparing themselves and have already prepared themselves for this, what seemed to be an inevitability of the rise in these numbers. So on one hand, it is quite a dramatic rise, but I think many places around the world, including our hospitals, have prepared themselves well for this possibility, for this rapid rise in the mortality and the number of cases we're seeing.
Okay. So you're on the front lines. What I'd love to do is go through a step-by-step process of how exactly this could take place in Canada, because we keep hearing again and again it's just a matter of time that it's going to make its way here. So let's begin with the testing process. If someone is demonstrating symptoms, if a doctor feels that this person needs to be separated, they need to be tested, how does that process work?
Well, firstly, when patients come into our emergency department, for example, here at University Health Network or many other hospitals across Canada, we ask a set of screening questions related to the symptoms and also a compatible travel history where we'd be worried that they are actually exposed to the virus. If they screen positive, we immediately isolate them in the appropriate precautions and in their own room with special features in that room to make sure that the virus isn't spreading. And then we will initiate rapid testing of that virus, which means taking appropriate samples from the respiratory tract and sending it off for testing. And in here in Toronto, for example, we'll be sending it off to Public Health Ontario, where they'll be doing, where they've already prepared to do this and to do it rapidly to test for the virus that's been identified.
Okay, so then let's imagine a scenario where one individual here in the city of Toronto, let's say at your hospital, does get confirmed with the coronavirus. They get separated from the group, you put them in the special room to make sure that they are isolated, but then what happens and how does the public become informed of what's going to happen next?
So I think we take a look at two aspects of the management of that patient. One is what we're doing for the patient in the hospital. So in terms of treatment for this virus, there are unfortunately no specific therapies, so we'd continue supportive treatment and monitor the patient closely, keep them on precautions, and provide the appropriate care like we would for any other patient. So have all the usual healthcare workers see that patient. And usually when these, in this setting, because of the heightened awareness, that will be reported up through Public Health Ontario and to the Ministry of Health here. And that information will invariably be made public to be made available to the public thereafter. The other aspect is what would we do? What's the management outside the hospital? In other words, what do we look at in terms of the patients before they came? And what I mean by that is making sure that we track whatever exposures a patient had prior to coming to the hospital to make sure there was no additional patients who might be affected or who were exposed directly from the index patient. And that's the responsibility of the public health agencies here in Toronto and also across Canada. Local health agencies would do that step as well.
Okay, so continuing on with the scenario, let's say it's more than one person. Let's say multiple people in a few different cities are now confirmed with the coronavirus. Then what happens?
Well, we would definitely take the same approach as with each patient that we see. So we would do what's called contact tracing. So we try to figure out where the patients could have acquired the virus and do our best to try to contain that. And that, again, is the role of the public health agencies across Canada. Within the hospitals, again, it's a similar kind of treatment. We would support the patient, make sure they remain on isolation, and make sure that there's no breaches in the isolation within the hospital. So we would make sure that everything is done appropriately, healthcare workers and other patients have not been exposed. And if the system that we've put in place has been done correctly, that would be very unlikely. If we see it in multiple cities and multiple locations, then a very intensive investigations will be conducted to figure out where it could have come from, what the source might have been.
Dr. Weisman, how close are we to getting a vaccine for this coronavirus?
As far as we know, this would be quite a long ways away. This would be in the range of several weeks to months, if that's even possible. We don't know what the status of the outbreak will be at that time and whether the vaccine will be available, how effective it will be, and whether or not it'll be deployed very easily to the places that are most affected by this virus. So for example, the areas around Wuhan and China. So we're not really expecting the vaccine to be available in any time soon, so that it might help contain this virus in the next few weeks or maybe even months. In the other outbreaks we've had with coronavirus, with SARS and MERS, we haven't seen a vaccine that's been effectively deployed or created during the time of the outbreak.
Now, a lot of the story is also the emotional reaction, the fear factor for so many people. So I want to break that down into two parts, which is how do you make sure that the public responds in a logical way and not one based on fear?
I think having the various professionals and experts come on to various media sources and discussing this is one way to alleviate those concerns. I think it's important for Canadians to realize right now that there hasn't been a single confirmed case in Canada yet. And the likelihood of there being an outbreak like we saw previously in SARS, for example, is far lower now due to the infrastructure we have in place, things that we didn't have in 2003. So I think that's a very important message that needs to be sent out from all the various health teams across Canada, that what we have in place now has a very good chance of preventing outbreaks occurring in Canada. And so we will hopefully continue to do that and make sure people are aware that this is not something they need to specifically change their behavior for on a day-to-day basis, and that we're informing them on a day-to-day basis as well about what's happening with the virus across the world.
Okay, Doc, now let's get personal, because you're working in a hospital. We've introduced you as being someone who's on the front lines. You're working with other people on the front lines. You're working with nurses who would be greeting people, folks in emergency rooms. People are coming in, they're coughing, maybe they have coronavirus, maybe they don't. How are individuals in the hospitals reacting? Are they nervous about this?
Certainly there's a lot of concern from the healthcare workers at our hospital. Certainly a lot of their experiences colored by the experiences of SARS. But the nursing staff and the frontline healthcare workers across the board have been extremely accommodating, extremely understanding. They are open, of course, to do whatever needs to be done. They are extremely cooperative. There has been no concerns from that point of view, despite the fact that this is a significant challenge to their day-to-day work, and despite the fact that this does pose a risk, despite how minimal it could be to them. But they have been excellent, and we've been provided with excellent support as well from the leadership at our hospital. And this has been true from across the board in various hospitals in Toronto in terms of the support from frontline staff, who have been excellent. On top of that, the leadership in the hospitals to recognize this problem and to support us very early on.
What do you think about the World Health Organization deciding yesterday to not declare this a global health emergency?
Although it wasn't declared an emergency, it doesn't necessarily change our approach across the world and how every hospital is managing this. Their approach is based on the likelihood of this virus having transmission events outside of China. So it's really based on that concept, is what's going on outside of China in terms of transmissions. And because there hasn't been any transmission events outside, that's the primary basis for them not declaring it a world emergency across the globe. But no matter what they decide with regards to that decision, we here and at other places are still continuing our heightened surveillance and education of the healthcare workers, education of the public, to make sure that this doesn't develop into a worse problem.
Okay, Dr. Vaisman, thank you so much for your time and for your insights.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Alon Vaisman is an infectious disease specialist with the University Health Network right here in Toronto.